next guest, Mr. Harish Radhakrishnan. Sir, may I have your permission, please? Thank you. Mr. Harish Radhakrishnan is the General Manager, Group Exim, Cyrus Poonawalla Group of Companies, which is engaged in manufacture and export of immunobiologicals, horse breeding and international merchanting. Sir is graduate in physics from Varia College, Pune, and has a degree in law from Pune University. He worked for 22 years in Central Excise and Customs Department, which is a part of Ministry of Finance under Department of Revenue. Sir quit his government service in the year 2008 and joined Serum Institute of India Private Limited, Harapsar, Pune, which is the largest manufacturer of vaccines in the world. He is handling the core areas of customs and central excise, service tax, and also CESS and EOU policy matters for the company for the last 8 years. Sir has been associated with different agencies and posts. Some of them are Vice Chairman, Export Promotion Council for Export-Oriented Units and Special Economic Zones, Western Region, set up by the Ministry of Commerce and Industry, Government of India. Member, Regional Advisory Committee and Public Grievance Committee of Customs and Central Excise and Permanent Trade Facilitation of Committee constituted by the Customs Department. Visiting faculty at various management institutes in Pune and Mumbai and a regular faculty member of MCCIA for the international business courses. Now, I request sir to kindly enlighten the badge.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Good afternoon to all of you. And a special thanks to Mehfooz, who was escorting me from my factory in Hadapsar to this place just now. And on the way, I had a little interaction with him. That is the information that I have about the institute and about the people who are going to meet me today. Special thanks to Dr. Govind for having invited me. It was my boss, Mr. Nambiar, who was supposed to come here to address this occasion. But yesterday, he had to suddenly go to Bombay, and because of which he couldn't be here. But then we could not, you know, escape this thing. So I was asked to put in, stand up in place of him. So I'll try and do some justice to the job. And at the end of the day, I'll ensure that you don't go to sleep and after your lunch that you've just had, and try to give you some valuable inputs which could be useful for you in your long run. So I consider myself 25 years young, the same age as you, and only with 30 years of additional experience. And that is something which I'd like to share with you and see whether you can make something useful out of it. I used to work for the Customs and Excise Department, and that is again a Government of India job which I had. I quit after 22 years in that department and then came out. But one thing special about that department was, it was a basic a chore police kind of a game that I was playing there. I had access to possibly all the industries in Pune. There may not be a single this one? Okay. Yeah, I'm audible?
Yeah.
So there's possibly no industry in Pune which I have not seen or visited myself while in the job. And I have a deep idea about what goes on in each of these factories, what they do for a living, and how these products which they manufacture come out into the market. On the other side, we also have a very big responsibility of managing the frontiers of the country, especially taking care of the influx of material from outside the country coming into our country, drugs coming in and going out. So all that was a part of the policing job that we used to do as a part of our customs function. Then over a period of time, we grew up as a country, and then we also got into an area called services. So service tax was a new entry, and that happened in 1994. So the Central Excise came into being in 1944. You have something called Central Excise and Salt Act. That is the act under which you levy duty on goods which are manufactured in India. right? So anything that is manufactured in India, and the normal definition is anything under the sun other than live animals and human beings are taxable, right? And how do you tax them? That is what the Central Excise Department does. And then whatever comes into the country, what goes out of the country, it has to be monitored, because you would not like somebody carry a bomb into your country and blast the place around. So there has to be checks at each and every entry point of the country, that is in the airports or the seaports, from wherever there is a possibility of a person coming in, that has to be monitored, and that is done by the Customs Department. Till 1994, we never realized that we could also gain some revenues out of taxing services, which we didn't realize. So we just blindly followed what the Britishers left us. We did not apply our mind to anything. And as a country, we have been very selfish people. We have been people who were the very least motivated and never bothered about anything that is necessary for our well-being. We just blindly follow things which are given to us. So when the Britishers left, they gave us these two legacies, the customs and the excise, and we blindly followed that without realizing whether it is good for you or bad for you. And as a country, we have always grown up in the Gandhian way of life, where you say, make something for your own use. Thoda sa bach gaya. It's okay if I just mix a little bit of Hindi and into my... So if you make something for your own use and you find there's a little excess, give it to your neighbor. And if you find you made good enough, give it to his neighbor. And that is the way our business models were designed. We always started doing small things and then trying to expand and grow into our business. And that is the way we've been working for the last 25 years. Now, first and foremost, I have to congratulate all of you for being the selective people who decided that I should study something more than what the old world knows. Yeah, let me hear a round of applause for all of you. Just clap for yourself. I have to specially tell you this because you have decided to specialize in some area of life. Whatever that area attracts you, you can proceed and grow up in that area. This opportunity was not available to us. It came to us only in 1991 after we decided that we need to do international business. We need to open up our country for people abroad, or we need to go outside and do business outside. I am told that there are very few people from Maharashtra in this crowd. Most of you are from outside. But in Maharashtra and especially in Pune, you have a very typical problem. These Pune guys are the most conservative fellows. They don't want to even step out of their own house. Their whole city is their bread and butter. They would not like to move out from those environment of that city. That is the way Pune developed. And today that is not going to help you at all. Tomorrow you have to go out of Pune, and you should not be surprised if everyone who's residing in Pune in the next 5 to 7 years will have to go and look for work in either Bihar or UP. Right? This I'm telling you right away on your face. Okay, this is the change that is going to happen in the next 5 years. Everyone comes to Bombay, Pune looking for job. This equation is going to change. You will have to move out of these cozy environments, and the development is going to happen in different places. Why it will happen, how it will happen, I'll give you a small brief about how these things are going to change the equation of the country. Another thing which I wanted to tell you is, you are passing through the best part of the human civilization. This is also something which I want to make you realize. All you younger generation, that is people who are born after 1991, they are lucky to be Indians. And today you are passing through the best phase of human civilization. There was never a time like this before. Aaj se 10 saal pehle, Professor Govind would bear me out ki things were very difficult. For everything you had to struggle. And today you have come to a situation where everything is available at a fingertip. Right, I was surprised when Mehfooz told me in the morning ki this course is actually run by people who come from the industry and guide you. So that means you have an institution where you don't have a permanent teaching faculty. So industry experts come and guide you. So this is something which you could never have imagined about 5 years ago. Right, these kind of changes are happening, and this is happening at a very fast pace. And everything that is happening around you is going to have a bearing on whatever you're going to do in future. So it is necessary that you keep your eyes and ears open, see what is happening around you, and based on that you will have to plan your decisions, and that is how the entire growth process is happening. This is not going to happen. In the past, when you got out of college, the first thing people did in Pune was try to find whether you can get a job in either Bajaj Auto or Tata Motors or you find a job in ammunition factory, because these were the areas where you had some kind of a job available. But today nobody wants to go into those organizations. Most of these areas have shifted. People have moved out of from those areas and they're going into newer areas. And all of you are possibly here only to see what are the new options that is available to you. I work for Serum Institute of India now. And Serum Institute is the largest manufacturer of vaccines in the world. Right? I want to say that once more. It is the largest manufacturer of vaccines in the world. And according to me, 90% of the people in Pune still do not know what is Serum Institute. They still consider it some kind of an education institute where some kind of a training is given. But it is a manufacturing facility and we manufacture vaccines and supply it to the whole world. Right? In India, you don't have anything that you make for the whole world. Can you imagine something? Can you just think of something that we make in India and give to the whole world? There was nothing. We never did it that way. Hum humara chota chota business. What I will do is make something for myself, something extra, give it to my neighbor, or thoda pad gaya to give it to the next neighbor. That is how we grew. But we never have planned anything for the whole world. And that is what is missing in us, and that is what we need to do. That is what all of you need to do. You have to start thinking big. Dream big. Ye chota chota chhod do. This is not for you. You have to start thinking big, plan big things, and then you will not fail. This is the way things have been moving in the world. But we missed the bus. We missed the industrial revolution because we were a part of the slaves in those days. When industrial revolution happened in the world, we were not considered necessary at all. So that's why we missed the industrial bus revolution. So nothing happened in that end. But we are a part of a big revolution that is going to happen, and that is the IT revolution. In that, the world cannot afford to ignore you. And without your presence in that IT revolution, nothing will move ahead. So you have to make the most of what is going to come in the IT area. Don't bother about manufacturing cars or manufacturing scooters and buses. It's not going to work. What you're going to do is something which is necessary for the whole world. So I'm very proud to be a part of Serum Institute because that is possibly the only company in India which manufactures vaccines for the whole world. And 2 out of 3 children born anywhere in the world are immunized using vaccines made by Serum Institute of India. And it is unfortunate that many people in Pune don't know that company because we are mostly concentrating on exports and doing business. We export to 142 countries all over the world. Some of those countries, the names I had never heard when I joined that company. Some countries are so small, and it is a challenge to have our products reach there. Secondly, when I talk about vaccines, it is a temperature sensitive product. If you remember in your childhood days, you have taken injections which were supposed to take care of your future. A lot of development has happened in those areas. There are some 5 or 6. In a country like India, the government of India feels that only 6 vaccines are necessary to keep our citizen alive. Country like Pakistan and Bangladesh, they need 8, 2 more than us. And a country like Europe or USA, they need 38 vaccines. So the spectrum is so huge. The Indian government feels 6 diya to bahut hai. You don't have to bother about anything else. But America says, mindset, every life there is important. So they need 38 vaccines. And even a country like Bangladesh and Pakistan needs 2 vaccines more than us. So that is the kind of sensitivity that our people show towards the health sector. So that is why people don't know much about us. And we are known for manufacturing affordable vaccines. Senior is, I don't make vaccine for making profits. Profits come automatically. But the motto of the company is to make affordable vaccines. Now to mention this, I need to give you a small example. There is a disease called meningitis A. Right? This doesn't come to anyone in India. It only comes to Africa. In the sub-Saharan African countries, you have some of these population, jinko ye problem hota hai. At birth, children die of meningitis. So the infant mortality rate was 27%. Means 27% of the children died at birth. And that happened only in Africa. And these countries were very poor. They didn't have hygiene. They didn't have money to even eat. Aise desh mein 27% of the people were dying from a disease called meningitis A. So there's Bill Gates and Melinda Gates. You would have heard their names. So these people are the guys who do a lot of charity. So Bill Gates and Melinda Gates Foundation, they went to these areas and found out that we should do something for these countries. And they made out a case and said, ki somebody can develop a vaccine for this disease. Because the virus strain was already isolated, you could work on it and develop a vaccine. But then because it was a poor country, no money with them, who would do it for them?
So that was the second challenge. Nobody wants to go into an area where there's no money. But fortunately, what happened in that Bill Gates meeting, our chairman was there, Mr. Cyrus Poonawalla. And at that time, this discussion happened. He said, let's give it a try. So humne bhi hasi mazak mein bola, let's give it a try. And we did that. So what happened is, for any vaccine to be developed, it takes about 7 years for the vaccine to come. You have to do all phases of clinical trials, and only then it can be given to human beings. But in this case, this vaccine was developed for the African subcontinent. We could finish the clinical trials fast. So in a period of 4 years, we could develop that vaccine. And it was administered them. We ran a campaign in that country for 2 years. And after that campaign was run, the infant mortality rate fell from 27% to 7%. That means we saved 20% lives of those children. And this is something which nobody could imagine some small country like India would do. That is the way the Europeans and the Americans look at us. And we were able to do that. But then this pleased him so much that he said, I want to come and visit your factory. So in September 2013, Bill Gates came all the way from his cozy environment to visit our factory. He saw the factory. And after that, he went and wrote on his blog about the factory. And that is the time the world realized, Kiare, this is a company which is of international standards, and the world does not even know that such a factory exists. And then we are not supposed to be tom-tomming our own products, because it is a pharma business, so we can't advertise our products or go on doing publicity. So in that event, what happened when this person came here and put it on his blog about the factory, so a lot of description and information about the factory came up. The world started taking notice. And then when things happened, people started coming to us. Tomorrow, if somebody finds a cure for HIV or a vaccine for AIDS is actually identified by somebody, it will be manufactured in Serum Institute of India. So we have the strength to do large-scale manufacturing of vaccines, and we can release 1 lakh and 10 lakh doses in just one day. So that is the kind of high-speed machinery and equipment that we have here. You would also recollect that we had the swine flu epidemic in Pune. Some of you were not here, I believe, at that point in time. And Pune was supposed to be a very deadly place when swine flu came. So when swine flu came, and anyone coming to Pune station, usko fumigate karte the. Anyone getting out of the aircraft had to be fumigated. The aircraft had to be fumigated. And people suddenly started treating Pune as some kind of an outcast. So you were not allowed to be anywhere close to the normal human beings. That was the kind of treatment that was given to us when swine flu came in. That was again one more incident where Serum Institute stepped in and did something in that thing. The swine flu vaccine was also, the virus was identified. We developed the first nasal vaccine for swine flu, and we introduced it into the market within a period of 4 years. And with that first level of vaccination that was done, we were able to contain that thing. Today, swine flu se logon ko dar nahi lagta. But if you remember those days, anyone coming to Pune, oh, darte the. Nobody wanted to come to Pune. All the aircrafts were, you know, flying empty. The stations were empty. That was the kind of fear that was created by the swine flu virus. So we are into the business of doing vaccines. And there are vaccines which are in the pipeline. Dr. Govind said I should speak about Serum Institute, so I'll give a little more information about what we do. So we are the first functional SEZ in the country. And we export to 142 countries, I just mentioned to you. And we have vaccines for different kind of diseases, some of them which are used in India, most of them are used abroad. And the main ones are DPT, that is diphtheria, pertussis and tetanus, that is given to all of you. MMR, that is measles, mumps and rubella vaccine. Then tetanus toxoid injection, which you get when you have some injury, that is manufactured by Serum Institute of India. And we manufacture this at a very cheap rate. Like I mentioned, that meningitis A vaccine, which I supplied to Africa, we did it at the cost of a cup of tea. So that was the cost at which we could manufacture those vaccines. And the most challenging factor in any vaccine business is the cold chain management. It has to be carried to whichever destination in that temperature situation. It is +2, +8 degrees. So you cannot have a vaccine which goes beyond 8 degrees. So carrying this vaccine from here to Africa in that temperature range is the biggest challenge. So because of which these vaccines turn out to be slightly costlier. We are trying to work on a system where we have a thermostable variety of vaccines in which these cold chain management problems are not there. This is in short about the vaccine business that we have. Poonawalla Group has got interest in different other areas as well. We have an aviation company, and it is called Poonawalla Aviation, where we have 2 or 3 helicopters and an aircraft. These are chartered. So when the IPL matches are on, when Shah Rukh Khan and his team wants to travel from Bombay to Hyderabad or to whichever destination, he uses our flight and we get paid for that. So we have an aviation company where we manage the chartering business. We also have a big interest in race horses. Like, for example, most of you would have heard about Poonawalla Millennium Race, which is going to happen next month. So we breed race horses in Pune, and that was a passion of our employer, and that is how this entire business started. We breed race horses, grow them, and till they are 2 years, so that is known as a young fawn division. At the end of the second year, you get to know whether the horse is fit for racing or not, and that is the time we have an auction in our stud farm. Then all the rich people around in the country would land up in Hadapsar, look for the horses which they want and then buy it off. And these horses are subsequently given for training. And then these are the horses which run the different races all over the world. Some of them are exported. Some of the horses have to be imported for breeding purposes. So that way you have a good pedigree of horses which are grown in Pune and then sold for racing purposes. Another thing which I wanted to tell you is, there is a big change that has happened in the business environment, and you need to keep a watch of it. So when you are doing management and you want to see which is the area that is going to attract you in future, so I would like to give you certain inputs and certain observations. And these are from my live experience in the Central Excise as well as from what I've been doing in Serum Institute of India. There is a huge change of business model after 1991. If you remember, in our country, we always made things and we sold it to the rich people first. If you remember, you've got mobile phones now. Before that, there used to be something called pagers. I don't know whether you've seen that. Ek pager ka bhi generation tha. Wo aaj wo kahin dikhta nahi hai. I don't know what happened to that. So, but when pagers came into the country, the first time the pagers were launched in Pune, it was only meant for the rich people. Mobile phone, when it came, it was only meant for the rich people. That is 16 rupees per minute. That was the kind of telephone charges that they took when they were launched in India. So we always had a concept of manufacturing products only for the rich people. And when the rich man is bored, he will give it to his driver, and then from there it will pass down. And that is how the entire development percolated to the people down below on the channel. This has changed. Today nobody does that. When you start a business, you have to now ensure how can you reach the smallest level of person in the society and make this thing available to him. This is the change that has happened here, which was not there in the past. Everything that was developed in this country, right from TV to refrigerator to whatever, it was all designed for a rich man, and when he got bored, it went down to the next level, and then that is how it came down. This doesn't happen these days. Today it is the reverse. You have to develop a product which will be straight away available to the smallest man on the street. And when he is satisfied, only then your business grows. Like I said in the beginning, you have to think big, dream big. And if you have to do that, it is to be done in this fashion only. We realized it very late. 1991 tak hum to soch nahi sakte the ki we are supposed to sell something outside this world to sustain ourselves. We have to import a huge quantity of petroleum oils, and you need to pay in dollars. And you don't earn anything in dollars because you don't make anything for the world where you'll get the money. So where do you get the dollars from? So that was the biggest challenge that the government faced in 1991. And that is the time they realized ki we should open up this economy and allow the foreigners to come in, or you go abroad and sell. These two things had to be done. You had to open your country. This happened only in 1991. And you are the guys who are born after that. So you are seeing the benefit of whatever changes happened in 1991. If you meet people from the generation beyond that, you will find that it was so difficult for them to sustain themselves. And today it is totally different. Now you have to grow and develop in that arena, in that area, and ensure how you go about getting the things that you want. I would recollect two or three examples which I wanted to tell you in this direction. The first fellow who designed this telephone for a smallest man was Reliance. Right, you've heard that Reliance mobile phone, when it was launched, it was designed in such a way that the smallest man could be able to afford a telephone. Buying an instrument from Nokia or Motorola, these were the only two instruments available there. And those mobile phones were 50,000 and 60,000. And that kind of money, who would pay for a telephone? That was the first connection. And then after that, you pay 16 rupees for a minute of call time. In this environment, Reliance came out with a new area, and he said, I will supply you the telephone and also provide you the connection. And he gave it to the people in the slums first. So the whole world said, ye pagal ho gaya banda, iska phone bhi chala jayega, paisa bhi nahi milega. That is the environment which he started operating, and he succeeded. And that is the model that has to be emulated by everybody else, and that is what is working today. And around the same time when Reliance came with this mobile phone for the smallest man on the street, we also had a comparable incident happening again in Pune. You have Bajaj Auto. Mr. Govind used to work for Bajaj Auto, he said in the morning. So Bajaj Auto, Rahul Bajaj made scooters, and we have an incident in Pune where he launched a model called MAT, which I don't know whether you all have seen, but there used to be scooters and a model of scooter called MAT. This MAT was such a craze that people had to go and sleep on the street one night before the booking started. They were on the street only to get a form to get a booking for that MAT. It's a moped, a scooter, or iska dono ke interaction wala tha. That the first time it was being launched in the country. And there was a huge riot that happened on the street because somebody tried to jump the line, and there was a police firing, and some two or three people died in that whole thing. So this was the level of importance which Mr. Rahul Bajaj enjoyed when the scooter business was there. And he was proud enough to come and stand on the longest platform and say, ki I can sustain myself by just selling spare parts to those scooters which I've already sold. Main agla 20 saal, 25 saal to sirf spare part bech ke nikal sakta. And today you can see that is not there. The scooter has vanished. You have not heard of MAT at all. Right? But this was a very big thing in Pune. Now, this kind of a shift in equation is something which we were not able to digest at all. Aisa ho sakta hai, ye nobody imagined. But then this has happened, and you are all, you know, a live example. You are seeing that for yourself, how this happened. Same is the case with Nokia. When this telephone came into India, everybody wanted a Nokia phone. There were only two options, Nokia or Motorola. And they wanted Nokia phone. And today this Nokia guy is nowhere in the market. And what you have is a Chinese phone which is there. And you also have Apple i6 and things like that. But these Chinese guys came into the market. They beat Nokia. That Nokia board is nowhere to be seen. And they have taken away the market. And all that happened within a span of 4 to 5 years. This is again something which nobody imagined would happen. Hum jindagi bhar wo purana Nokia phone leke chalenge. So today I have made as a motto of my life, ki never buy a phone costing more than 10,000 rupees. I am not bothered about whoever is the manufacturer. 10,000 rupees se jada costly phone lena hi nahi hai. I made it as a motto for myself. That is because you buy a phone for 40,000 and in 10 days you find a better one has come and this 40,000 goes for a toss. So that is the kind of equation that has come in here. So you have to decide what is the price. Now once you say I will not buy a phone for more than 5,000 rupees, the Chinese guy is going to make a phone and with all the features that you want for 5,000 give it to you. But if you say the only phone available is Apple i6 and I'll pay 60,000 for it and stand in line like a fool, then that is the only phone that is going to be available to you. So you have to make this shift very fast. And this is where all of you come in. You will be some kind of marketing people or some kind of technical analysis and things like that which you will be doing. These are the factors which are going to be there. I'm trying to just open up a Pandora's box for you and tell you these live examples which is just happening right in front of your eyes. Maybe you have noticed it or maybe you wouldn't have seen it at all. But this is very much there. Another thing that has happened here is in 1991, the top business houses in the country, there were 20 people in that list. Right, after 10 years, or top 20 people in that list, out of 16 of them have vanished. The richest 20 people in the country in 1991 are no longer there in that list in 2016. In 2016, that list has been replaced. From that list of 1991, only 4 guys are there. The rest of them are all new people. And who are these new people? That is something which you need to just observe and find out. Ye naye kaun hai? So always you would imagine that a rich would always stay rich, usko koi nahi hila sakega. Those are the kind of people who would normally appear in an industry's list of top 20. In that top 20 in 1991, the top 20 list, there are only 4 people who are presently there. They have been replaced, and they have been replaced by new faces. These top 4 people in the list, they are the guys who are beneficiaries of the British leaving India. When Tatas were there in the picture, Birlas were there in the picture, they were all there during the British times. When the British went away, they had a huge legacy which they could manage, and that is how they started the business. This Ambani was the first man to come on his own grit and get into that league. After that, you have got a lot of these IT companies who have come in, set up business for themselves and come into that league. This change has happened in the last 20 years. That is where you grew up in the last 20, 25 years. This is a big change that has happened. So what I'm trying to emphasize is, you should not be surprised if you are able to design a system for yourself, or design something for the society and get into that list yourself. That is the kind of canvas that you have open for you today. The government has come out with a new scheme, Startup India, Skill India. You would have heard it in the news, Narendra Modi shouting on the top of his voice. Some of you said it's not possible, some of them accepted it. But this is here to stay. This is going to happen. You are supposed to do all these different things so that you are taken notice of, and that is how you are going to grow. Two, three things which I learned in my earlier days is, you can sell your products only when there are human beings. Jahan pe human beings nahi hai, aapka koi product ko koi kaam nahi hai. And please imagine, human beings are in India, they are in China, and they are in Africa. These are the three places where there you have a huge population. There are a large number of human beings in only in these three areas. Europe is slowly receding. America is trying to balance itself. But you have a huge set of population in India, China, and Africa. You cannot ignore them. We cannot be ignored by anyone in this world. If you ignore India or China, you cannot do business, because this is where the bulk of human population resides. So wherever there are human beings, you can do business only in these countries. And today human beings, fortunately, when we were growing, you had a huge problem. Everyone in the world said, India ka population itna grow gaya tha, we will just go into the Indian Ocean. But then there were some scientists who worked in that period of time and said, ki aisa kuch hone wala nahi hai. We are still in a proper frame of mind, and we are able to sustain ourselves. And that is what is yielding results today. So the population which they complained about in the past is possibly the workforce that we have today. We have 65% of our workforce in the age group of 25 to 45. This is the only age in which you can work. 45 upar thode bude ho jate hai, so you cannot work with the same energy and zeal. And Europe is full of people more than 65. So they cannot do their own things, they are going to need your help. And human beings are the only species in this world who are designed to help others. No other animal is designed that way. Aapka jo body ka design hai, that itself is made to help others. You have huge long arms. Very few animals have arms, right? All your body design is done with an idea to help others. And your entire survival is going to base on how you're going to help others. Only think about it. Don't think about manufacturing cars and scooters. Manufacturing revolution, we missed out. We are not going to be a part of it again, because at that point in time when the manufacturing happened, industrial revolution happened, we were slaves of the British and they did not allow us to do anything at all. Today is the time where you can do something. What can you do best? You can help others. And that is the basic design of the human beings. You have got the special ability to help others. How can you help others is what the whole challenge is. That is where the whole game lies. What area of human problems can you take up and try and help a person? This is where you have to concentrate your energies, and this is where you're going to get your business. I need to also give you a small piece of statistics. When we were in 1947, when the Britishers left us, at that point in time, we had 3 to 4% rich people. The rich in India were only 3 to 4%. We had middle class, which was 7 to 9%. When the Britishers left, they were 9%. By middle class, I mean people who could have their daily sustenance ke liye methods available. This is what was the position of our country in 1947. And the rest 88% were poor. They did not know what to do. Some of them were doing menial labor somewhere, but their identity was totally lost out. But in 2016, the equations have shifted. And today the rich, they range from 12 to 16%. So what was 3 to 4% is now 12 to 16% people can consider themselves as rich people. The middle class has suddenly grown to 54%. And 54% middle class is a very good equation to have. Ye hum America ke barabar hai. With 54% middle class, that means this is the class of people who can, do business, who can buy products, who can sell products, and who can do some kind of a commercial activity. So today we have got 54% of people who are actually middle class, and the poor is the remaining, that is 30%. But in this 30% also, day before yesterday, there was a new discussion that started. He's saying there is something known as a new middle class. So the poor are no longer poor. It is something called new middle class. Now what are this new middle class? This new middle class are these guys who are basically the people who are helping you at home. you have your drivers, you have people who are helping you cook the food and all that. These people also earn enough money for themselves because the middle class grew up. These people are also getting enough money for themselves that they can also afford a mobile phone. Just imagine 98% of the 125 crore population of India has a mobile phone today. 125 crore is the population of India. Usme se 98% ke paas mobile phone hai. They are using it. That is the total sale of mobile phone that happened. So once you have that kind of mobile phone available at the disposal of the common man on the street, you cannot say that they are ignorant. Mobile phone chalane ke liye kam se kam you need to count 1 to 10 to punch that number. So everyone is capable of doing. Even on the road, when you go in the morning, you find the sweepers who come to sweep the street, they also have a mobile phone. While they're sweeping with one hand, their phone is on the other hand. So this kind of technology has now come down to the level of 98% of the people have this phone at their disposal. And this is what is going to make a big change. Now you also have to look at another statistics. When we began, we had 16% people in the manufacturing sector. Right, that is the industrial areas. We had 24% people in the agriculture sector. They were kheti baadi karne wale, 24% the. And about 16% people who were working. And the rest were all unaccounted, 44%. Unko kya karna hai, what they were doing, they wouldn't know. So we had 44% of the population who were not clear as to what their bearings were. But today that equation is again changed. The manufacturing sector, which was 16%, has gone to 18%. That is 2% growth in the manufacturing. Agricultural sector, which was 24%, it dropped to 13%. That means some of the farmers left farming and went somewhere else. Where did they go? So all these farmers would normally come to the cities in search of employment, and they would normally go into the industrial sector. But that did not happen in our country. None of the farmers entered into the industry. They entered into the service sector, and that is the new sector that opened up. And today we have 50% of our people working in the service sector. And what is the service sector? It is about IT. Whatever helps you can give to all the people in the world is what this IT business is all about. Sitting here in Pune, you're going to decide which train is coming to the, which plane is going to land at Heathrow Airport. Some Britisher has cut his finger while getting down from the aircraft. And he's claimed an insurance for that. That insurance program is settled here, sitting here in India. Now, in our country, if you get down from a flight and then you have a small cut on your finger, you don't even go to the insurance company. But they don't do that. But then that insurance settled here in Pune. All these back office operations for the European companies, for the American companies is done in India. And that is this sector which has opened up from 1991. And that is the service sector. Now, you have to only try to find out areas where you will be able to help. So in your industry, they normally say in your management theories, plan your work and work to your plan. And that is precisely what you need to do. You have to keep your ears and eyes open, look around what is happening around you, and you will get a lot of ideas of what is happening. Have you heard of a company called Page Industries? Koi suna hai Page Industries? So it's really strange. Nobody has heard about Page Industries. So Page Industries is a company which is the share price, a 100 rupees share, a 10 rupees share price of that company is today 16,000 rupees. Lekin aapne company suna nahi hai. You know what this company does? This company sells you chaddi baniyan. This is jockey. That jockey underwear which you wear or the baniyan that you buy is made by Page Industries. The cost of a 10 rupees share of Page Industries is 16,000 rupees today. Why did it happen? So Page Industries you never heard, but jockey you've heard. You walk on the street, even on this road, you will find that every third shop, you will find a black jockey board put up there. Right? 125 million population of India. Everyone needs minimum 2 chaddi and 2 baniyan. Just imagine what is it in numbers. Then we said, you don't wear the cheaper ones, I'll give you costlier ones. They gave you all the fancy stuff. And you started buying. And that is the history of Page Industries. Right? This is what is happening right in your presence. If you go walk on the street, you will find a lot of changes that have happened in the last 5-6 years. The boards on the shops have changed. Previously, everywhere there used to be a grocery shop. There used to be a cycle puncture shop. there would be a stove repairing shop.
Ye sab gul ho gaye.
Do you see this now? But what has come in place of those shops? Just make an observation when you walk on the street tomorrow. You will find that every alternate board is Jockey. Every third board is Nokia. He has vanished now. So it's only telephone companies, people trying to sell you Airtel or whatever, Vodafone. These are the things which have mushroomed all over the cities. Where did they come from? This happened only in the last 5-10 years. And what happened to the guys who were running the shop there? Where did they go? So there has been a migration happening in that area. So how many of you use bullet motorcycles? Only two. Achha, two, four. This is another revolution that happened. You heard of a company called Eicher Motors? Yeah? Achha, ye suna hai, Page Industry nahi suna hai. So, Eicher Motors is a company which was manufacturing trucks. Right? And suddenly somebody, a young man from that generation, they took over that factory. And this Enfield, that is the bullet manufacturers, it was a south-based company. And they were selling bullet motorcycles. Only policemen used to use bullet motorcycles, and everybody who wanted a bullet only wanted it because a policeman was using it. And Amitabh Bachchan used to sing all his songs sitting on that bullet motorcycle in the movies of the old. So that was the only attraction to that bike. So over a period of time, maintaining that bike was so costly that even the police could not afford. Obi Bichara bullet bechke, he came back to Kinetic Honda because he had the ease of operation. So maintaining that bullet was very difficult. And two things changed. Firstly, that bullet motorcycle is again something which the British has left for us. And then they never did anything good for us. Whatever they did for us was just for their own benefit. So bullet was one such motorcycle, jisme har gaadi ka brake hota hai, wahan uska gear hai. Aur jahan gear hota hai, udhar brake hai. Iska ulta tha setup. That means once you buy a bullet, you get addicted to that and you continue with that. Because it will be difficult for you to go to the other vehicle. Now this was a problem which somebody smelled and realized. I also wanted to have a bullet. Another problem that came along with the bullet was when you try to kickstart that bullet, uska ek back kick hota tha. Wo back kick itna zor se hota tha, kuch logon ke pair bhi toot gaye uski wajah se. So these two things were attracted to that bullet motorcycle because of which nobody wanted it. This guy, Eicher Motors fellow, uska father ke baad he went and studied abroad, came back here, he said, I want to do something different. And this guy took over Enfield Motors. So Enfield Motors is today a part of Eicher Motors. And this guy, the younger generation fellow who came in, 2-3 changes he made. Pehla kaam usne ye kiya, left ka right kar diya. I want to make it at par with any motorcycle that is available here. We are the only country jahan pe aaj bhi right hand drive hai. You go to US, you go to the other countries, it's all left hand drive. Ye Britishers ne janbujh ke humko ye karke gaye the. So that you stay addicted there. Wo hamara hi gulam ban ke raho. So senior is because you are having a right-hand drive, your roads are designed that way, your traffic management is designed that way, and a left-hand drive leke agar aap aate ho to custom mein mera dost aapko rok dega, left-hand drive India mein lana allowed nahi hai. So what do? You have to convert it into a right-hand drive. You never had access to technology. All my life, all my childhood days, I just grew up watching 2 or 3 types of cars. One was Ambassador and one was Fiat and the third was a Standard. There was nothing else available for us. That was because of this design. Left-hand drive, right-hand drive, kyun hona chahiye? Another thing which came up, the shirts that you wear, and the ladies also wear shirts these days, the button of the shirt from the ladies is left to right and the gents are from right to left. Ye kyun hona chahiye? Ye bhi kisi ne nahi socha. This was again left by them. Ye shirt ke button ka jo direction hai, ulta hai. Why should it be ulta? It was because the British has designed it that way. Jo, the men folk have to wear their own shirt. For the ladies, there would be somebody who would help you wear a shirt. So the person who is going to help you wear the shirt has to stand in front, to usko ulta hona chahiye. To uske convenience ke liye kiya hua hai. That is the way the entire designing has been done. Today what happened when we wanted to grow as a country and we wanted technology, nobody was ready to give us technology. Tumhare pagal desh ke liye kaun bana ke dega? Left hand ka right hand bana ke do. But today you see what has happened. I need to take you to 1985 when we decided, Sanjay Gandhi decided to do Maruti car. That was supposed to be a poor man's car away from the design of what you see today. That is how Maruti Udyog was set up. So we wanted to manufacture a small car in India. And at that point in time, the only country or the only company that manufactured small car was Volkswagen. Volkswagen had a car called Beetle. Yeah, that was designed during the World War. Unke wahan parking problems bahut the. So they wanted to design a car which can be just lifted and put on the parking and then taken out. So they started off designing a small car with that kind of a background. But fortunately or unfortunately, they could not do it. But when we wanted to make a small car in India, so we had to approach these collaborators. So we went to this Volkswagen guy because they were the only guys who had small cars with them. But when we went to them, they said, you are too poor a country, hum toh tumhare taraf dekh bhi nahi sakte. So they refused to give us technology. They refused to collaborate with us. And the only collaboration that we had was Mercedes-Benz. We had Bajaj Auto and Bajaj Tempo, just neighbors. Bajaj Tempo had OM616 Mercedes-Benz engine. That was an engine which was designed in 1960. And they had written off, they had grown from that area. And sabse purana jo model tha 1960 ka jo engine, usne humko diya, garib desh hai, chalo ye le lo aur khush raho. And we got that into our country and we were so proud to make a vehicle out of it. And that is how the industrial revolution began here. And Volkswagen were the guys who said, you are too small a country, we are not interested, we cannot do business with you. And that is the time the Japanese came in. Suzuki Corporation, life mein kabhi koi car nahi banaya tha. Wo log outboard motors banate the aur generators banate the. But that technology is somewhat similar. They said, chalo, let's join hand and make a car. And that is how Maruti started in India. It was refused by Volkswagen. A company who never made car came in and said, I'll help you make a car. And today, 70% of the business turnover of Suzuki Motors comes from Maruti. We also make money, but the Japanese also made money. They learned how to make car along with us, and they are world leaders today. But what I want to emphasize is, the same very Volkswagen, which refused to do business with us, 5 years down the line, they are now in India. They are very much in Pune. They want to make their car in Pune, and they have set up a factory in Chakan, where they make the latest models of Skoda and Volkswagen cars. And senior is, people who were so proud and so rigid about their way of doing business had to change. They are the guys who said, you are too poor a country for us to have any interest. They did not want to come here, but today they are forced to come here. And today the ball is in your court. You can decide whether you want that stupid fellow's car or not. Right? So this kind of a shift in equation is something which we could never imagine before 1991. But this is all there very much here. Now going back to the bullet story, Eicher Motor, 6 years, 7 years down the line, the cost of an Eicher Motor share was only 650 rupees. Today the cost of that share is 19,530 rupees. Nobody could imagine. Yesterday somebody sent me a calculation. In 10 years back, if I had bought a Bullet motorcycle, it would have cost me 1 lakh. Had I not bought that Bullet and bought shares of Eicher Motor, I would have made more than a crore today. So that is the kind of shift that happened right in front of your eyes. And this is very much there in this market to stay. Another big phenomena that is happening is Baba Ramdev. Yeah? You heard anything about it? Yeah? Sorry?
Yeah.
Nee, business mein kya revolution kar raha hai?
Yeah. Today, especially in the morning when I left my office, I got this page just to show you. Do you read these papers?
Economic Times or Financial Express ke saath aata hai, brand equity. Aap bhale koi paper nahi padhna. Just read these pages. Right?
This will have a lot of story and information for you, which will be of interest. Today I bought this paper all along because Indian Startup and Patanjali. There was a small story on Baba Ramdev and how his business starts. Please make it a habit to read these papers. Right? Ye Economic Times or Financial Express ke saath aata hai. Usme bahut se small small tidbits rehta hai, which is going to be of use to you. So I bought it precisely to show you what it is.
Baba Ramdev started a business venture. His turnover is 5,000 crores. 15-16, turnover is 5,000 crores and in the FMCG space, and he is wanting to do that, take it to 10,000 crore in next year. 5,000 crore ka 10,000 crore usko next year karna hai. And you tell me, how is it possible? Or what did he do so as to make 5,000 crore? Uske closest competitors, all along when we went to watch movies, the only advertisement we saw was Vico Vajradanti. Right? Do you remember that advertisement which appears? Even today it appears the same way. That company has been in existence for so many long years. And today the turnover of that company has just reached 150 crores. Uska nearest person is Dabur. doing the same kind of products. Uska turnover is just around that much, 200 crore ke kareeb hai. And this man comes from thin air suddenly and 5000 crore. Why did this happen? And nobody is able to understand ye kya hai. Management mein they want to introduce a new chapter on religious based marketing and things like that. New fundamentals have to be invented. But all this happened because he did something different from everybody else. What did he do different? He studied the market, he studied the situations around him and tried to encash it. So what I'm trying to come at is, stay focused. You have to plan your work. If he said he had good principle saying humko sabko jo hai paisa hamare desh mein hona chahiye, nationalist feeling came in. Don't let the multinationals take away money from your country, let the money remain here. That was one of the motivational factors which is connected with Ramdev's business. He came about doing yoga. He could connect with people and he did yoga with lakhs of people. Aisa ek do logon ke sath baith ke ek room mein nahi kiya. He just connected with people, lakhs of people, and along with them he had a big audience with him. He could communicate well and then he came out with these products. Now what did he do? If you look at the packaging of each of those products and you compare it with the products manufactured by the multinational company, you will find that this is all very much similar. There is not much difference in that. How did he achieve that? Again, he kept his eyes and ears open. What did he do? See, the government of India comes out with a lot of schemes and policies. One such scheme was when that Uttaranchal was formed as a new state, they wanted to have industrial development happening there. So how do you do that? They said anyone who starts an industry in Uttaranchal will have a 10-year tax holiday. That means whatever duties you are supposed to pay on the central excise side, for the first 10 years you don't pay any duty. Right? So because of this incentive, the duties that the government charged was to the order of 17% and 18%. Agar aapka product 18% cheap hai, then anyone would like to go there. So most of the companies who went to Uttaranchal, they went to Baddi. They were the guys who had established pharmaceutical business in developed areas. People went there because 16% is a good benefit to have. So they went and set up their packaging shops there. You make the basic drugs, take it to that Baddi factory, from there you package it and release from there. You get 16% savings on your excise duty. Now this is the way the business was designed. It was designed so that that state developed. It was a newly formed state, industry not developed. So for the development purposes, they sent that people there. Now when these people went away, we as Indians, we are not very clear about what we want to do. You have a huge mafia operating in that state as well. They also ensured that this banda jo hai Bombay se factory shift karke agar Baddi aa raha hai to kuch kamane ke liye aaya hai. And he also equated how much is he going to earn. He said 18%. 18% is a good amount of money. So they said, you might as well give some money to us also. So the underworld that was operating in those areas, the transport lobby which was there, out of that 18% benefit which was going to come to you, they said 4 or 5% should be given to us. Now some of these people who are doing ethical business, they said this is not the way to do it. So the capacities which were created there for manufacturing, there's a big incentive, 18% less, so huge facilities were created. They had a lot of idle capacity. This Ramdev went to those guys and said, tumhara factory band pada hua hai, aapne do din chalana hai, uske baad mein band hai, so you make my products. So that technology to manufacture that product, especially packaging and making it in the way it was presentable in the market, that was readily made available to him. He used that and in the shortest possible span, he could just load his products into the market. And that is how the success started. What I'm trying to tell you is, please observe around you. Please find out what the government is doing different and try and take advantage of that. Most of the business of Ramdev Baba is based on this 2-3 principles which was there. You have to be watching for these kind of signals and that is what is going to help you do business in the near future. You plan your work and work to your plan, that is what is said. There's another area which I need to tell you. Nobody is interested in handling your problems. Sabko apne apne problems hai. Wo dusre ka problem solve karne ke liye koi banda ready nahi hai. Now that is one area where you need a lot of people to help you out. So if you are able to find out any area where there are problems and you can have a solution to that problem, that is a potential business model for you. You have to identify these kind of things. There is a company where I was working in the government. There is a company, there's a person who used to come for the service tax purposes. And this man comes and meets me once in a while when he files his returns or he has some problems, he comes to meet me. Once when he came to me, he said, sir, aapko agar finance minister ke saath koi appointment chahiye ya prime minister ke saath appointment chahiye to aap mujhe bataiye, main karta hu. Ab wo bande ko dekhne ke baad to laga ki ye ek ordinary sa banda hai. And this man says, if you have any work with the prime minister of the country or with the finance minister, I will help you out. And that is the time I really wanted to know, what is this fellow up to? I got hold of all his returns and whatever taxes he was paying. He was providing cleaning services, right? And he was paying 20 crores as service tax. He was paying 20 crores as service tax. If a man is paying 20 crores as service tax, his business is worth 200 crores, right? And what is this man doing? He is only providing cleaning services. He said, I can arrange a meeting with the prime minister or the finance minister. That is only based on the fact that he was cleaning the parliament, he was cleaning the prime minister's house, he was cleaning the finance minister's house. Have you heard of this company? So this is something which you meet every day. There's a company called BVG Corporation. You go to any mall, you will find the guys who clean that mall and keep it spick and span are the people from BVG Corporation. These guys are out to clean the buildings and premises. You go to any IT park, you will find that the buildings are kept spick and span. That is because it is subcontracted to these guys. So just by sweeping and cleaning the floor, a person can pay 20 crores of tax to the government. That means he can do 200 crores of business. ये हमने आज तक कभी नहीं सोचा. झाड़ू मारने वाला 200 करोड़ कमा सकता है. Has it ever crossed your mind? But then this is a business model. There are competitors now who are competing with that fellow, but he is still the market leader. He cleans any premises anywhere in the country. He says, tomorrow I'll go and clean the White House also. Right? So that is the kind of vision that fellow has, and this is the kind of business model that people have to now look for. You have to help others. You have to help others in solving their problem. Your problem nobody is going to solve. That is your own baby. You have to take care of it. But see for opportunities where you can go and solve the problems of others. And that is where the entire business lies. Another thing which I wanted to tell you was, be observant and see what is happening. Another revolution which is going to happen in the next 6 months, which is just at your doorstep today, is this Reliance coming out with the second kind of a stuff, which is Reliance Jio. Right? They come to coming with the 4G services, and he is planning it big. He says, I'll just come and hit the whole market with that service, provide you internet speeds which you cannot imagine. And that is the kind of working that is going on in Reliance for Jio. But when that is going to happen, there are already players in the market. Airtel is there, and the others who are slashing the prices. And that is only done to keep the competitor out. So when that happens, you are necessarily going to gain out of it, because you are going to get products which won't be as costly as you would imagine. This is going to happen in the near future. And with that, the entire internet history of India is going to change. Please keep your eyes open and see what is going to happen with Reliance Jio and Airtel in this next near future when that is launched. Make that a case study. Go up behind it and find out whoever is doing it. That will make some kind of an interesting stuff for all of you. So I just wanted to give you a small idea about this is happening. Just follow it up and see, you will find that there are different areas where you will be able to manage your things. Another thing which happened was a revolution that happened just last week. There was one big Rajni movie got released. Right, most of you. Sabne dekha? Koi nahi dekha? Toh phir ye aapko college ne chutti dena chahiye when entire Tamil Nadu could give a leave on that day. Right, just imagine one person could brand his product in such a way that a state is compelled to give you leave just to watch a movie. Now what did he do? And what did the others do differently? Shah Rukh Khan was also there, and Salman Khan was also there. They got into all kinds of bans for their movies. They tried to get all kinds of problems for their movie. But this guy did not do that. He did not get any adverse publicity for his product. But on that day one, people were waiting in line to buy a ticket and watch a movie at 1 o'clock in the night. How can you catch the imagination of so many people just by doing something ethical? So this is a big challenge that is there. I need to tell you one more thing. Even if Rajnikant dies in the next 4 or 5 years, this Rajnikant movies can still be made. This will still come. Because they have caricatured him in such a way that even when this man is not around, movies with his bearing can be released. And I'll tell you for sure that still they will be standing in line to buy a ticket in the night. So this is the kind of development that has happened around one person. his whole family is involved in that, in projecting him in the way he's done it. And one movie, just it is history for you, just find out what all happened. He did it as a revolution and it worked. 500 crore is what they made in that first 1 week. And this is something which you could not have imagined. These kind of different things, different approaches to problem is what you need to look for. Another thing that is going to come up is the startups. Startup is going to be a very big thing, and you are all supposed to be looking around for startups. And when you are going to do that, please have a look at this newspaper which I just showed you. It gives you a lot of insight into what these startups do. And what I need to specially emphasize is there are a lot of people who are actually running the brick and mortar companies, and today they have retired from their active life and they are supporting the startups. You have Ratan Tata who is funding a lot of startups. You have Narayan Murthy who has come out of industry with the money that he has. He is doing funding a lot of startups. But what are these startup companies in the end? These are all companies which have the potential to solve human problems. If you can identify a problem and work out a solution, you have a business model coming out there. You are not going to work for anyone. You have to make up your mind that I am going to own a business and I am going to provide jobs to 10 different people. If that is the motto that you make, you become successful. If you find that, no, I am going to get out of this college and look for a job in Tata Motors, it's not going to work. So that is not the way these things are designed. You took the special pain of coming out to a management institute to specialize in an area so that you can do something for the society. And what can you do best? You are supposed to help others. In that process of helping, you're going to design a business of your own, and that is what is going to get success to all of you. There is every change that happens around you has an economic opportunity, and you have to look for those changes. And if you want an example of what is happening here, diesel vehicles are banned in Delhi. This is a government order that diesel vehicles are cause of pollution, so because of which the diesel vehicles have been banned. And if these diesel vehicles are banned, what is the option that you have? See, the option is you have to move out to petrol. And you have got two market leaders in India. One is Mahindra and the other one is Mercedes-Benz. Both these guys are only operating on the diesel space. So today they are also thinking of manufacturing vehicles with petrol engines. So when a problem comes, along with that you have a solution, and that solution is going to get you a business model. These changes are happening. The next best revolution that is going to happen in the next 15-20 days. That is when we go into a major transformation on the taxation side. We have, like I said in the beginning, we inherited all our problems from the Britishers. It is for the first time that we are going to do a big adventure on our own and try and get a taxation system for us, which is going to be of use to everyone in this country. So GST is going to come. So it is a single point tax, goods and service tax, which is going to eliminate the entire thing. And what is going to have is you have to change your entire business model to suit the GST requirement. So I advise people whenever I go for any of these talks that when you grow up and you have to find something for the children, please don't think twice. Straight away send them to a college where they can become chartered accountants. Is duniya mein sabse ja India mein aaj ke baad, in another 2 years time, you are going to need a lot of chartered accountants because we don't have those many. With this change in taxation system, every business model has to go through the same grind. Today you have chartered accountants who cater to the requirement of only the income tax and the sales tax side. Just imagine 1,65,000 SSEs are going to be added, each one of them having all kinds of complicated businesses and all of them needing the services of a chartered accountant. And a chartered accountant may be restriction, one man can only handle so many clients. Then you have to make partnership firms between you, make partnership firms and grow. So one huge area that is going to open up after the GST comes in is the chartered accountancy space. I don't know whether you can also become chartered accountants after this. So if there is a possibility, you should all jump into that wagon and see how you can make the best out of it. Secondly, when this change happens, first time in this world, in this country, we are going to have a system which will be totally based on IT. It is going to be a computer-based and electronic-based assessment practices, electronic-based invoice practices. All that is going to need a huge amount of electronic support. You need to have a lot of computer interface for each of these operations. Most of the companies have computers, but then most they will have to switch. They will need people who can do this work. So a huge opportunity is going to open up when the GST comes in for the IT placement as well. So TCAs and the taxmen and IT enabled processes, this is where the opportunity lies in the next 2 to 3 years. So you are there at the right time. Just by the time you pass out of this college, this thing will be in place, and that is the opportunity that you need to grab. So you should design your systems here in such a way that when you get out into the market, you are able to find something in this area. And you should grab each and every opportunity that comes your way. I came here today because Mr. Nambiar was supposed to come here. He had to go to Bombay. So somebody needed to come. So I grabbed the opportunity to come and talk to you and try to have this exchange with you. And in this, I just try to pass on some information about my company, where the world is heading to, what is the areas where you need to keep your eyes and ears open and see how you can grab the opportunity that comes your way. I have shown you ideas that these are all going to come. And in the, on the way, when I was talking to Mehfooz, he was there with me in the morning. So he said, you also have a foreign tour connected with your program. And you normally go to Dubai and Malaysia and Singapore. But I would like to advise you, don't go there. Go to Europe. Right? All of you, if you get a chance at this age, you should go to Europe. They are 50 to 60 years ahead of us. Whatever you do here is for them. And you can have an idea of what they need. You can plan your work in such a way that you are able to deliver the right things. So this is something which is necessary. In those olden days, we could not afford air travel, so we couldn't go abroad. But the things are different today. You can always have the luxury of traveling abroad once. Even if you have to borrow money, you have to take money on loan. But make it a point to visit at least one European country, one industrially developed European country. Then you will have an idea of where we are heading to and what is it that we are going to find in the near future. Then in India, nothing works without some kind of a spiritual support. And we always work with God men and things like that. I am a non-believer kind of a fellow. But then still I can understand how the Indian psyche works. Have you heard of a man called Devdutt Patnaik? Yeah. Only Dr. Govind has heard, aap log nahi suna. So again, you are not able to find what is there. Please Google search, find out Dr. Devdutt Patnaik. And he works for the Kishore Biyani group. And he has a very typical designation. His designation is Chief Belief Officer. Agar aisa kisi ne aapko post diya to aap loge? His designation is Chief Belief Officer. He works for the future groups. It is Dr. Devdutt Patnaik. And the speciality of this person is, any problem that you have in your business, you take it to him. He can relate it to some epic, either Ramayana or Mahabharata, and give you a solution to that. When somebody connects your problem with the Ramayana, Mahabharata, Quran, whatever religious text that you have, uske saath connected aapko ek solution dega. Aur Indians ko agar God se connected solution, they are very happy. And they take it blindly even without trying to verify. So please find out from the Google, Dr. Devdutt Patnaik, and you will find a lot of interesting material available with him. And I don't know whether you have televisions in your rooms here. Yeah, if you have television, do you also get Epic channel in your, yeah, anyone watches Epic channel? Usme ye aata hai, right? Just see when, next time when you see that Epic channel, just watch. That Epic channel is again something which is done by Reliance Group. It is the Indian equivalent to National Geographic or whatever. But a lot of interesting facts are there. Please, at least once, have a look at what this Devdutt Patnaik says. You will find a lot of relevance to whatever is there. There's another man whom I still respect. It is Jaggi Vasudev. You heard his name? Koi follow karta hai? Okay, one person there. So please go to the net, find out Jaggi Vasudev and see what he has to say. Again, he's one fellow like our Cyrus Punawala, who's honed his aircraft, his Ferraris and things like that, gave it up and became a spiritual guru. He doesn't tell you what to do, this thing. But whenever you have a problem, a solution is always given to you. And that solution which he gives you is always, you know, acceptable. And you can, there's no, what do you call, nothing unverifiable that he states. So these are 2-3 spiritual supports which I just wanted to recommend. I have a point of looking at it. In the morning when I go to my office, 10 minutes, and then I start my day. So please do that, that will help you. Thank you very much. I can take questions from you if you have any. I'm not certain if somebody went to sleep. So from here at least I couldn't find anyone sleeping. Yes, ma'am.
Good afternoon, sir. My name is Sheetal Dubey. I am from Bhopal, Madhya Pradesh. Sir, as you told about your company, the manufacturing of it. Sir, you told that the company one vaccine was manufactured at the manufacturing cost of T. Sir, I just want to relate it one thing. Sir, a few days back, when news was there that the medicines which are manufactured at the cost of 35 paisa to 50 paisa, they are available to the customers at the rate of something between 90 rupees to 120 rupees. So almost 250% of the manufacturing cost. So what is the main reason behind that? And why is this thing really necessary?
Okay. So it's a good question. Are you recording this? So then for 2 minutes, don't record. So because let me give you a straight answer to what this is. Like you're saying, there is generic medicine which is available to you. And paracetamol and crossing. These are the two live examples that you can have. You go and buy paracetamol. This pharma business is all about making a fool of you. Right? So this powder with paracetamol.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon.
Sir, it has been known that most of the medicines which are available to us, they are
being banned in the foreign countries like USA and all, like crossing and disprins. But yet, in India, the manufacturing of these medicines are going on and people are consuming it. Why is this so?
Okay, so I need to correct you a little. Crocin and Disprin is not banned. Disprin is the only medicine which is there for such a long time in the history that it did not go out of the market. Yeah, Disprin is very much there. Crocin is also very much there. There are other medicines which have been banned. And why they have been banned, what it is, I'll tell you. We as a country, we always feel that, you know, hamara ilaj ekdam jaldi hona chahiye. I don't want to come to the doctor frequently. Ek bar agar main doctor ke paas jata hoon, with that he should be able to cure my illness, however complicated the illness. In that whole process, what has happened here is, we have developed combination medicines. You have paracetamol with diclofenac. Diclofenac is a painkiller. Paracetamol is an antipyretic. The antipyretic medicine is supposed to reduce your temperature. जब आपको बुखार होता है टेम्परेचर आ जाता है वो टेम्परेचर रिड्यूस करने के लिए जो मेडिसिन इज पैरासिटामोल इट इज सपोज टू रिड्यूस योर टेम्परेचर एंड डाइक्लोफिनाक इज अ पेन किलर तो व्हाट दे डिड दे कंबाइंड बोथ दिस एंड गिव इट टू यू सो इन आवर कस्टम्स डेज वी यूज्ड टू हैव अनदर मेडिसिन विच वॉज बेसिकली कॉल्ड द स्लीपिंग डोज which you have, which is normally a 5 mg dose is supposed to be a sleeping pill. But if you take 2.5 mg of that medicine, it is a muscle relaxant. So you feel very relaxed. So when you do a night patrolling and things like that and come tired in the evening, you have one crocin with that 2.5 mg wala dose of sleeping pill which is built into it. And you get a nice sleep, next day you're fresh to work. So right, these kind of combinations were made available by the government, by the pharma companies. And that is what is banned. So technically the government did not ban the basic drugs. They have banned the combinations which have been there. And this combination is not required. So you go abroad and take a medicine. They will never give you a 2-in-1, 3-in-1, 4-in-1 medicine. You will have to buy different ones and then take it as per your requirement. Humne ye sab shortcut nikala. Ye sab mix karke de do. Sab ke liye ek hi ilaj. So that is what has been banned. But then when you ban a medicine, what happens? Have you ever brought a crocin strip from the medical store? Did you ever see a warning on that? You never seen. Anybody from Tamil Nadu here? Why? Nobody from Tamil Nadu, nobody from Rajinikanth's place. Okay. Tamil Nadu is the only state in which if you buy a strip of crocin, it is written there. Taking excessive paracetamol is harmful for your liver. Ye humare cigarette boxes mein jo labels hai, waise pharma labels bhi hai. So it is a requirement of that state. That state is extra vigilant, so that is the reason why they have that. So combinations have been banned, but then Indians cannot survive without it. Aaj ke desh, when they talk about pollution, right? Green gas effect and things like that, your ozone layer depletion and all that. The problem aisa hai ki jo European fair skinned people, unko skin cancer hota hai because of ozone depletion. The fair people in Europe and America, Unko skin cancer hota hai because of ozone depletion. So the Americans and the Europeans are telling you, don't cut the trees in your country. Because if you cut the trees, there will be more green gas, greenhouse effects, and because of which they will get cancer. So my thinking is that why should I be bothered if that Gora fellow gets a cancer? He has cut his trees, he has made his whole house of trees, he has ruined the whole environment, and today he comes and tells me that you don't cut your trees. And mujhe cancer nahi hota. If I cut my trees, mere ko cancer nahi hota. So should I cut the trees or not? So that is the question that you have today. So most of these things which were developed by the foreigners, it has come down to us. And today they are facing problems. So we are saying we will not cut the trees provided you give us carbon credit. Now I am trying to tell him that if I don't cut my trees, I plant so many more trees, itna ozone protection hoga, jiske wajah se tumko cancer nahi hoga. So for that you pay me a price. And that is the scheme of carbon credits which is now in the process. So it is pure, you know, commerce that is working today. And most of the medicines, it doesn't affect us. But then it has a effect on the European people. So they start shouting, ye ban kar do. They say 80% of Indians would have diabetes. Right, so all of you will have diabetes when you grow old. That is the calculation the WHO has made. So it is based on a calculation. What is the value of sugar or cholesterol that a person can have? So usne ye dekha ki ye gareeb desh tha, like I said in the beginning, hamara population, we were poor people, and they were not bothered. But the moment we came into that middle class lot with some kind of a money which we can spend, they suddenly altered the ratios. जो 110 लेवल और 200 लेवल जो कोलेस्ट्रॉल हाई कोलेस्ट्रॉल का वैल्यू था दैट वाज नॉट 200 इट वाज 250 तो 250 से 200 कर दिया तो सो मेनी मोर पीपल आर सपोज टू बी कोलेस्ट्रॉल इफेक्टेड पीपल सो स्टार्ट टेकिंग मेडिसिन सो मोस्ट ऑफ दीज आर ट्रिक्स विच हैव बीन प्लेड बाय द यूरोपियंस ऑन टू अस वी नीड टू टेक अ कॉल ऑन दैट सो इट इज अ कॉम्बिनेशन मेडिसिन विच हैव बीन बैंड एंड इट इज नॉट गुड फॉर यू एंड मी इफ एट ऑल यू हैव अ प्रॉब्लम यू शुड टेक दिस मेडिसिन सेपरेटली इट विल टेक अ लिटिल टाइम फॉर इट टू फिल्टर इन
Thank you so much, sir, for your inspiring words. I'm sure the batch has learned a lot. Now, we take a quick break of 10 minutes and be back shortly.